Governor of Abia State, Orji Kalu, was convicted and sentenced by Justice Mohammed Idris on the 5th of December 2019. But the Supreme Court in May 8, 2020 nullified the trial and conviction on the grounds that the judge who handled the case lacked jurisdiction. Based on the Supreme Court judgments, Kalu filed a suit at the Federal High Court to stop his planned retrial by the EFCC. Delivering judgment on the suit, Justice Inyang Ekwo holds that the Supreme Court in the verdict did not order the retrial of either Kalu or his firm, Slok Nigeria Limited. The court notes that the Supreme Court only ordered the retrial of former Director of Finance in Abia State, Jones Udeogu, who was the appellant before it. Consequently, Justice Ekwo upholds the suit against the planned rearrangement of Kalu by the EFCC. The court said it will amount to double jeopardy if he faces the same trial again. The court holds that there was no extant order that directed the retrial of Kalu. Justice Inyang then ordered the federal government and its agencies not to retry Kalu. But the court ordered the retrial of former Director of Finance in Abia State, Jones Udeogu. Counsel in the matter reacted to the judgment.
It's a triumph for the law. It's also a triumph for the Constitution. They are party to this case, and they have to abide by the order of the Federal High Court as well as the Supreme Court.
Certainly, that was not our position. We believe that there is no way the applicants in the two applications can really be severed from the charge, and the Supreme Court could not have said, yes, it's only one of them that should be tried again and the others should be left alone to go without trial, because eventually they enjoyed the benefits of the Supreme Court judgment pronouncing the entire trial that was done initially a nullity. Most likely we are going to appeal. That's almost certain. But we will review it, our position with our clients. By the time we review it, the position will certainly be made public.
For now, Kalu can be enjoying his freedom pending the outcome of the appeal by the federal government. Joseph Kadri, ITV News, Abuja.